Hello, friends. So, this is the latest issue of The New Scientist cover story, Rebuilding Reality, a bold new way to think about how the universe fits together. A bold new way to think about how the universe fits together. To think about how the universe fits together. Rebuilding Reality. The author of this article is Heinrich Paas, a theoretical physicist at the Technical University of Dortmund in Germany, and the author of All Is One. All Is One. He should have gone a little further and said all is one mind, all is one consciousness. But let me read you a little bit of this article because it's definitely progress, but needs some more progress. So I'm going to read a little bit and then comment a little bit. Reality reconstructed. It's time to ditch the idea that everything is always made of smaller stuff and instead think of the universe as a single quantum whole, says physicist Heinrich Paas. Imagine you could see through everyday objects to the stuff they're made of. If you zoomed in on the arm of a chair, say, you would see that it is made of atoms. Zoom in again, and you would see that those atoms contain subatomic particles called protons, neutrons, and electrons. Zooming further still, you would see that the photons and neutrons are comprised of quarks. These are the layers of reality, and this is how physicists understand the universe, by breaking everything down into its constituent parts, an approach known as reductionism. As a particle physicist, I grew up on this philosophy. It has brought physics a long way. It is how we built our current picture of matter and its workings, after all. But now, with further progress stalling, I'm convinced we need to go beyond, we need to go about things differently from here. Rather than zooming even further inwards, I think we need to zoom out. In doing so, we may see that everything there is, including such seemingly fundamental things such as space and time, fragment out of a unified whole. They emerge from a unified whole. This might sound like philosophy or mysticism, but it is in fact a direct result of applying quantum mechanics to the entire cosmos. When you do that, you realize that the universe isn't fundamentally made of separate parts at all, but is instead a single quantum object. It is a radical idea, and one which we are just beginning to test experimentally. But if it is correct, it could help solve some of the most puzzling mysteries in physics, and upend the way we think about the universe. Okay, then he gets into very detailed math, and you know what he calls effective field theories, and talks about Higgs boson, etc., etc. Technical details that we don't need to get into at the moment. But towards the end, he says, as we proceed up the scale, size scale, and as we proceed up the size scale and down in energy, the effects of lower energies could be broken by a process called decoherence. Which is, you know, how the wave function collapses. One of the theories is decoherence. But then he actually goes on to talk about quantum entanglement as being the universal principle throughout the cosmos. And then he says, if we do find evidence to support this idea, it would dramatically alter the way we conceive of the cosmos. It would mean we could not only see a world in a grain of sand, as the poet William Blake once said, but we could also quite literally see the entire universe in its tiniest pieces and particles. What this might sound like, while this might sound like just a different way of going about physics, it is much more than that. I believe we are on the way to a completely new understanding of how the universe is put together. So, not bad, coming from a scientist. But where is the missing element in this article? The missing element is that the universe is not only a quantum entanglement wholeness, that means everything is quantum entangled, everything, but it is a quantum entangled mind. Because these theories would be impossible without the mind. The mind is the common factor, and even mind is not a good word, awareness. Because what we call the mind is a species-specific modification of that awareness. So, in fact, the universe is not just a unified whole, not just a single quantum whole, it is a single quantum entangled awareness. And each of our minds is part of that one entangled awareness. And what this article says, and yet does not say, is reality is constructed. But where is it constructed? In consciousness. Without consciousness, you can't do science. You can't come up with these theories. You can't make observations. You can't design experiments. And nor can you come up or conceive these theories. So we have to go one step more, my friends. And one day we'll get there. You are the whole universe, you and I, and actually every sentient being is the whole universe as one awareness. That includes plants, that includes every sentient being, that includes us humans, innumerable points of view, in that one consciousness looking at itself as the universe. Because what we call the objective universe, including quarks, particles, force fields, are actually perceptual and cognitive activities in that one consciousness. So who are you? You are the universe looking at itself from a unique point of view. You are the holo movement as a body mind entangled with that which you see. But that which you see is not an objective world out there. It is the interpretation of our own perceptual and cognitive activities in the one mind or in the one consciousness. So each of us inhabits our own universe, but it is the same universe, seen as a holo movement from a particular point of view. You and I, and this is the observation deck which the universe is using to look at itself from a unique point of view. In the deeper reality, we are members of one mind, one consciousness, and one body. And we are not rebuilding reality. We are understanding reality as that one invisible, irreducible, fundamental, formless, infinite, entangled awareness experiencing itself as infinite knowers, infinite modes of knowing, and infinite objects known, except they're not objects, they're perceptual activities and cognitive activities of our own self. We see the universe and we call it that out there, but it is us appearing as that. And if we really understand that, then all of science has to be revised. Tell me what you think. I find this very exhilarating.